Hello children, I welcome once again in our today's English session. We are on page number 29, lesson number 30, The Adventures of Gulliver. Lesson number 13, The Adventures of Gulliver. Gulliver's Travel is an interesting book written by a well-known English writer, Jonathan Swift, in which he described the voyages of Gulliver to various lands like Lilliput and Brobdingnag. Though the character of Gulliver and these strange sounding lands are imaginary, Gulliver's experiences and adventures are written so well that they seem real and true to life. Gulliver, the story tells us, worked as a surgeon on ship. As such, he made several voyages. In May 1699, he sailed on ship the Antelope on the return journey. In November, a violent storm sank his ship and Gulliver swam to save his life. Late in the evening, he found himself marooned on a strange land. Weak and exhausted, he slept for about 9 hours. It was daylight when he woke up. Let us read what happened next in his own words. Gulliver meets the Lilliputians. I tried to get up from the ground, but I could not move. I was lying on my back. Then I found that my arms and feet were held down to the ground with strings. My hair, which was long, was held down in the same way. Thousands of strings had been passed across my body, so that I could not move any part of me, but could only lie there on my back looking up at the sky. In a little time, I felt something alive moving on my foot. Then it came over my body and up to my face. Turning my eyes down as much as I could, I saw a man. He was not half a foot high, but by his dress, he seemed to be a soldier. Then there came 40 more, following the first. I was so much surprised that I gave a great cry. Then they all ran back in great fear, and as I was told later, some of them were hurt in jumping down from my side onto the ground. Gulliver attempts to pull free. After pulling very hard, I got one arm up from the ground. I also raised my head. This gave me great pain, for many of the hairs were pulled out. I put on my hand to catch some of the little men, but they ran away before I could close my hand on them. Then I heard a noise and felt a pricking in my hand like that of 1,000 needles. I found that there were shooting arrows at me. I was afraid for my eyes. I put my hand over my face. After this, I thought that was wisest thing to do was to lie quiet till night. I thought that then, my hand being free, I could quickly set free the rest of my body. Soon a platform was raised and an important looking man gave a long speech. For his gestures, I guessed that he was trying to tell me that they would not harm me if I did as they told. I too replied with gestures that I would remain quiet. I also told them that I was hungry. Gulliver eats a giant meal. At once, 100 men climbed up onto my body and marched up to my mouth, carrying food. The bread was as small as bullets, so I ate 2 to 3 loaves at a time, and cries of surprise rose from the Lilliputians that I should eat so quickly and so much. The Lilliputians were no longer afraid of me. They danced upon my body and ran to and fro. I could have caught at least 40 of them with my hands and thrown them down, but I remembered my promise to remain quiet. Indeed, I was surprised at their bravery, for I must have seemed the greatest giant in the world. Later, I was taken to the city where the king lived. A great cart was made by joining many carts. 900 men worked for 3 hours to put me onto the cart, which was drawn by 1,500 of king's finest horses. The city was just half a mile away, but the journey took almost a full day. Gulliver's New Home, page number 31. The king came out to meet me. He came near and looked at me, but it was not thought safe for me to climb up on me. At the place where the cart stopped, there was an old church. It was the largest building in the whole country. For certain reasons, it had not been used as a church for many years. I had now been made ready for me to use as my house. The great door on the north was 4 feet high and 2 feet wide, so I could go into it by going down on my hand. One of my feet was set in a great ring on the end of many strong strings, so that I could not get away but could only walk some distance outside my door. The country outside looked like a garden. After some days, the king and his people were convinced that I would not harm them. So, after I agreed to keep certain orders of the king, I was allowed to move around. Gulliver visits the city and the queen. As soon as I was set free, I asked if I might see the city. The king was pleased to let me do this. Orders were given to all the people to remain in their houses. I then stepped over the wall and went carefully along the two large streets. All the windows were full of faces looking out at me, and a large number of people were standing on the tops of the houses. The king's house was just at the place where two great streets meet. There was a beautiful garden on all sides of it. Lying down in the garden, I put my eye to the windows. The room inside were beautiful. In one room, I saw the queen and some of the young princes. They were greatly pleased by my visit. So, children, we read a lesson named The Adventures of Gulliver. This story is about a man called Gulliver who finds himself tied down to the ground in a land of very tiny people called Lilliputians. At first, he is unsure of how to tackle the little people of Lilliput. Finally, Gulliver learns to behave as he is asked so that he will not be harmed. Ultimately, Gulliver befriends the Lilliputians and is set free. So, children, on page number 83, there are quick questions. Write those in your notebook. And also complete your workbook in neat and clean handwriting. Thank you. Bye.